the only one, I can assure you.
There is T.T.Ying, beaten finalist 12 months ago, trying to go one better in 2014. Her opponent is Sung Ji-hyun of Korea. So T.T.Ying, the 20-year-old from Taipei. Third Super Series final of the year, having won one title, the last one in Hong Kong. Her opponent, Sung Ji-hyun, 23 years of age, from Seoul. This her first Super Series final of the year. Months ago in Kuala Lumpur, T.T.Ying walked out for the final. She left as runner-up, having been beaten by the Olympic champion Li Chui-rei. But the way she's played in this year's tournament has been an absolute delight to watch. Lost the last of her group matches, the group decider against the teenager Kane Yamaguchi, and in the semi-final beat the fans' favourite, Simon Awol. Sung Ji-hyun, the 23-year-old Korean. Well, she's only the second Korean to be in the women's singles final here at Super Series finals. 4 years ago, Bae Yong-ju reached the final, and she had to settle for second best against Wang Shexian. Well, Korea have won two titles at Super Series finals. One men's doubles back in 2009, and one earlier today, men's doubles once again. Well, there's quite now a height difference, isn't there, between
white
these two players.
Or blue?
Blue.
White.
Sung Ji-hyun, tall player. 175, that's 5'9". Opponent, 162, that's 5'4". But Morten, you and I have just been delighted by T.T.Ying's array of shots over the week.
Yes, she has played an awesome tournament so far. I know she lost the group to Yamaguchi, but that match was... the outcome of who was going to the semi-final at that time was decided, and I felt that she could probably lift her game a little bit more than what we saw in that match. And apart from that, she has been outstanding. I think she is standing a very good chance of winning the honors today, but I was impressed with her opponent yesterday when she played Yamaguchi and the way she outplayed the Japanese.
Yeah, I absolutely concur. Yeah, in fact, I'm not a betting person, but if I was, I probably would have put money on Yamaguchi. I thought she was playing so well. But T.T.Ying has delighted us, not just with her winning, but in the way she's won. And for her, this is a third final of the year. Of course, she won in Hong Kong, the last of the Super Series events of 2014. And reached the final in Japan as well. Well, her first two matches on Wednesday and Thursday were against former world champions Ratchanok Intanon on the Wednesday and then Wang Yihan on the Thursday. As we've talked about, she lost to Yamaguchi, but semi-final against Simon Awol came from a game deficit to win 21-9 in the decider. So to Sung Ji-hyun, and currently number five on the world ranking. This is her fourth final of the year from 17 tournaments. Her semi-final against Yamaguchi, as you can see, was very convincing indeed, 13-13. And that, as we've already said, was a huge surprise to both Morten and myself, the ease with which she won. But she deserved to win with ease because she really did play very well indeed. So our umpire for this one, Simon Au from Hong Kong, and Zhao Xiaomao from China.
Ladies and gentlemen, judge. On my right, Song Jin-hoon, Korea. On my left, Dai Shi-ying, Chinese Taipei. Song Jin-hoon to serve. Love all. Play.
So the women's singles final. Song Ji-hyun of Korea nearest to us against last year's beaten finalist Tai Su-ying. Now already we've, in that very first rally, seen
service
one of
over.
The delightful skills of Tai Su-ying. This is incidentally the 11th meeting between the two players, and of the previous 10 encounters, honours are shared. 5 wins apiece, but the last time they met was in the quarter-final of the Asian Games individual. And in the individual event, Tai Su-ying reversed the result of the team competition because Sung Ji-hyung had beaten the player from Taipei in that women's team competition, but revenge for Tai Su-ying in the individual competition. And of course, Tai Su-ying went on to take that bronze medal at those Asian Games. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, favourite shot from the Korean Song Ji-hyun. She absolutely loves that shot, and that's one of the things that Tai Su-ying really have to watch out for. And we saw it yesterday against Yamaguchi, how effective it was. I think it's quite impressive. How old is Tai Su-ying? She's 20, isn't she?
She's 20.
How come these two players have played 10 matches already against one another?
Yeah.
That is amazing, isn't it?
It is. Finds the back line. What a good start by Tai Su-ying. And Chinese Taipei has never won a title at the Super Series finals before. So the 20-year-old has an opportunity to make history. Oh, that's a nice clear.
Yeah, but well recovered. She got out of trouble. Yeah. Song Ji-hyun can't really believe what happened there.
Oh, look at that. She's toying with her opponent.
For the time being, yes, she does. And I remember yesterday, you said to me, if I could describe Sung Ji-hyun to the viewers, and I said she's a very solid player, but if there is a department where she's not so strong, it's actually pace-wise. The fact that she's not moving as quickly as some of the others.
Yeah.
And that is totally exposed at the moment. This is where she's good.
Yeah.
Service over. G7.
Gone wide.
3-7.
Set
Service over.
It's almost, Morton, to me, as if Song Ji-hyun looks a little stiff in her legs as she's lunging forward.
It's because of the deception of the shots from her opponents. There's always a little disguise to it, and that means that Song Ji-hyun cannot move, you know, early.
Yeah.
She's always caught, and that is a big, big problem for her. Going wide.
Ten, three.
That one, that final shot from Tai Su-ying. Song Ji-hyun must have seen so many times, she must punish her on that one. That was not well enough. That shot, she got away with it.
And that's wide. 11-3. 8-point advantage. We've had just a little over 5 minutes. What a start by Tai Su-ying.
And I think this is the recipe for Song Ji-hyun here. She's got to start to attack a lot more and take initiative, be the controlling part in this match, because otherwise she's getting into a lot of trouble.
Service over. 12-4.
Well, that's not a good sign for the Korean, because Tai Su-ying should not really be able to get away with a win on that one.
Well, the luck of the net call, but I'm not sure Song Ji-hyun would have been ready for that either.
No, it was a winner. Unless it... not coming over at all.
Yeah.
But it would have been a winner. Racket on the wrong side.
Service over. 5-13.
Hear when the umpire was doing the toss of the coin whether one of them chose ends?
No, I did not hear.
No.
Or I did not notice.
No.
If I may say so.
Thank you. 13.
Yeah, this is much better for Sung-Chi-Hyun here.
13.
As I said earlier, she's got to go in and control, and on this run of points, she has played some very good attacking shots.
Yeah.
Which for the match is really great, because that forces Tai Su-ying out of her shell. She's got to start thinking whether she has to really open up and play even better attacking shots, and that's where you have the competition.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh.
Crikey, that hardly seemed possible.
15,
take that.
Nine.
That's a good shot.
Isn't it? I thought she had to go straight. Yeah. Look, she's not really behind it.
No.
And it was almost like a Rafa Nadal finish to the, you know, his forehand, the way the racket came back up over her head.
Yes.
Oh, sweet.
She can walk on water at the moment.
16.
That's a good shot again. But it's exposing the lack of pace of Sung-Chi-Hyun here. She's not even able to react to it, let alone get it, but not even reacting to it.
Oh. Well,
the idea is really good.
Had gone the wrong way, so you're right, the idea was good. Just
16.
Wide.
But that's what the Korean has to do. She's just got to scramble, get as much back as possible, try to get into attacking situations where she's best, and see if she can score the points and minimize what her opponent is doing. Look at that, that's pace again. Look at that. But well played by the Korean, really sticking to her guns and getting it all back. Getting this one was really good as well, giving the opportunity to Tai Su-Yin to actually make the mistake.
Sung-Ji-Hyun has managed to halve the one-time deficit at the mid-game interval, that 8-point margin. Only 4 points in it. Oh, that's a good smash. That's in as well.
Service over. 17-12.
But look at how she's almost forced to run around herself. Look at that.
Yes. She's looking for that cross-court net shot.
17.
Yeah, really, the only option.
Yeah, but it is one of Tai Su-Ying's favourite, isn't it?
Yeah, but it was the only option to play, and they're obviously well covered by the Korean here.
Seventeen.
She's a little bit impatient. Play some of her good attacking clears as well. That would help her a lot, I think. That's just 3 points in it now. Korea has done well, which is promising for the second game.
18-14.
I thought for a second it was coming over.
Wasn't far away, was it?
No.
No, this is
16.
That's what
19.
I'm saying. She's a little bit impatient.
Yeah. And all of a sudden, it's got extremely interesting. The psychology of it all comes into play now. Oh, look at
she
that.
Doesn't like that one. Oh, that's still well left. Sung Ji Hyun really doesn't like that reversed 20. Slice there from the forehand.
Yeah.
She's completely wrong-footed every single time.
So four game point opportunities for Tai Su Ying.
Service over. 17-20.
That was good length. As you can see how Tai Su Ying is standing, she had no chance of playing that shot. She was too far from it. That's out.
Gone wide. 21-17, the scoreline in the opening game.
First game won by Tai Su Ying, 21-17.
17 minutes and one game to the goods. Tai Su Ying. Will that be Chinese Taipei's first ever title here at the Super Series finals?
These four shuttles are for warming up for the next match.
Second, level play.
So Tai Tsu-ying of Chinese Taipei, just one game away from making history. Oh, look at that net shot. In fact, it's been a good year for Chinese Taipei, hasn't it? Because Chao Tien-chen in the men's singles
has done really well as well.
First ever Super Series title for him, the French Open.
Yes.
And that completes Taipei's victories in all five disciplines at Super Series level.
Yeah, and obviously they've been quite good in men's doubles for a number of years, and their best pair qualified here as well.
Yeah, as the number two seeds. It's wide.
Service over. 1-2. Service over. 3-1.
Good pressure.
Yeah.
Very good pressure.
Service over. 2-3.
Well, presumably, Morton, Tai Tsu-ying's punch clears, those deceptive flat clears like that one, are going to be even more effective from this near side of the court because, of course, she's hitting into the drift.
Yes. Yeah, we discussed that a little bit in the mid-game interval here.
Mm.
Not on air, though, but yes, I definitely think that will help her game quite a lot. Not that she needs it, most likely, but... I think one of the biggest problems for Sung Ji-hyun here is the fact that, I don't know if you noticed, that cross-court smash from the round-ahead position where her favourite shot is completely taken out of the equation every single time Tai Tsu-ying is there and she blocks it, which means that the Korean have to run quite a lot. So she's got to find other ways, which she actually did here on that smash. But her favourite smash seems to be totally out of the equation at the moment.
So?
Going wide.
It
oh
is.
My goodness, she's taken it and then stopped.
She thought she played a winner. See, that's where the attacking clear comes in. That cross clear there.
7-4.
Yeah, interesting that Tai Tsu-ying immediately after the rally looked back towards that corner where we thought the shuttle was going out. That's where she stopped, wasn't it?
Yeah, hear that attacking clear. look at the situation the Korean gets into.
Oh, that's ridiculously good.
I like your language.
It's such a joy. Marvellous.
It is.
Look at this.
Quick one.
Removing some of the tape, I think.
From the shoulder or from the elbow.
Elbow.
From the elbow. Interesting that Tyson Ying stayed on court as if to say,
I'm ready.
The umpire, I'm ready.
Absolutely. I would have done exactly the same.
Yeah.
That's a classical example. See how Tyson Ying is stepping into it. The drop shot playing the cross, and see how Sung Ji-hyun really have to scramble on that one and cannot control the length of her shot.
Service over. 5-9.
Good judgment.
Service over.
And that's what we talked about, the drift to play here. And obviously it's more difficult for the Korean and it's easier for the Chinese Taipei player.
So a 6-point advantage here for Tyson Ying. Well, on Thursday earlier this week she went down from number 6 in the world to number 9 in the world. She wins these Super Series finals. I wonder how much she'll go up again.
Good play here, very good play by Sung Ji-hyun. Good pressure on the backhand side of Tai Su-ying.
Service over.
What a return of serve.
She really, you know, she's just got this feel. I said earlier, she can almost walk on water.
Yeah.
And no matter what she's doing, she's feeling comfortable. She plays good shots, whatever she's doing. On a few occasions, she plays these odd ones out and all that. But 95% of her shots, they're just naturally there, and she doesn't have to think at all.
Yeah.
So, playing.
her favourite one.
7-13.
Yeah, this time, because it was such a... This one was good. That's opening up very nicely. And suddenly space is there.
Service over. 14-7.
She's turning the sport into an art form. It's artistic the way she plays her shot production. There's another wonderful touch.
15-7.
Under normal circumstances, that would have been a winner for the Korean player. But look at this. Look how tight this one is. And then, okay, I'll just play another one.
It's amazing.
Out. Service over. 8-15.
Yeah, 9, that's good length 15. On that shot from Sung Ji-hyun.
And here suddenly these points are creeping in, these mistakes are creeping in. I don't know if it's a little bit of impatience or it's just because she's actually a little bit overconfident and believes she can get away with anything.
Service over. 16-10.
Overdone it.
Service over. 11-16.
It's cool, good.
Service over.
It is in.
Yeah.
17-11.
And well, again, a beautiful disguise.
Yeah, perfect. Points away from the title. It really has got the Midas touch at the moment.
She has. I'm convinced that in the future we will see Tai Su-ying in consistently in the top three. I think she, if she can keep producing what I've seen in the last few months, I think she will be consistently in the semi-finals in the future.
Yeah.
And then from there, anything can happen. But I think she's sort of stepping up one level here.
19-11.
2 points from the title. Outrageous if that had worked.
It would be.
Mm. ready to pounce.
Yeah, it did not go over.
No, forced next her opponent into error. And now 8 championship points. That's gone long. Game. 2 straight games, 21-17, 21-12. And Tai Su-ying has gone one better than a year ago. Here in Dubai in 2014, she is the champion. And what a deserving champion too. Confirmation of the scoreline, just 35 minutes. For 21-17, 21-12. Well, she's been an absolute joy to watch all week as Tai Su-ying. And I think after the first 2 days, Morton, when she beats 2 former world champions back-to-back, Ratchan Rukintanon and Wang Yihan, we knew she was in form. We knew she was in form because she won the last of the Super Series events prior to the Super Series finals, the Hong Kong. But she's just grown in confidence.
She has. And when I predicted on the first day, I think I said she will win the tournament. And that was due to the conditions here. The last 2 days, she's been forced to play badminton. She could not just rely on her strength and her shots and all that. She was forced to play badminton, and she stepped it up again and played beautiful badminton.
Yeah.
And the funny thing, you know, I look at this again, she hardly got a chance to celebrate because that one, the last shot was just going out and okay, thank you very much. And and that was it. She didn't even have a chance to celebrate it. And I feel that's a shame. You know, she has played so well this week. It's unbelievable.
So did you always like to hit a winning shot when you were winning a championship rather than see your opponent make an error?
That's much more fun.
It is, isn't it? You see the winner go, you leap in the air.
Yes. Yeah. We can sort of picture ourselves, can we?
Well, what a performance by Tai Su-ying. Well done to her.
Absolutely.
Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 and the women's singles.
So the prize presentation for the women's singles. The third Super Series event where no Chinese players in the women's singles finals. Our dignitaries make their way onto centre stage. 2 Chinese players, of course, started the week here. They were the number 1 and 2 seeds. But these 2 players really have played so well throughout. and especially the champion, Tai Su Ying.
The medals, checks and trophies will be presented by Giselle Pettifer, Vice Chairman of Falcon & Associates, Moza Almari, Board Member of the Dubai Sports Council, and Ben Yoniyama, President of Yonex. The runner-up in the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 women's singles from Korea, Song Ji-hyun.
Song Ji-hyun of Korea. Well, it was her first Super Series final of the year, a fourth final in total, and for a second time in 2014, she's got to settle for second best. Outclassed in today's final, her opponents really did have the Midas touch.
The winner of the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 Women's Singles from Chinese Taipei, Tai Su Ying.
Tai Su Ying, a sixth career title, a fourth Super Series, and she makes history by becoming the first player from her country to win a Super Series Finals title. Not only did she win, but she won in absolute style. The artistry of her play, the creativity, and the big smile shows the delight for what she's achieved.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Women's Singles 2014 from Chinese Taipei, Tai Su Ying!
Tai Su Ying, champion here in Dubai. And what a deserved champion she is too. Not only the trophy and the title, $80,000 prize money as well for Tai Su Ying. Our next match, an all-Chinese affair there, the former World Junior Champions Li Cheng and Ba.